Alright, what's good everyone? Game Day J back in the place to be. Thank you guys for tuning in and much appreciated. This is Evolution Worlds on the GameCube, played through the Wii's GameCube, RPG game, originated on the Dreamcast. I still have my original GameCube, I still have my original Wii. I know a lot of people sold their Wii when they got a Wii U. I still have my Wii U, and I still have my Wii. And I still have my original GameCube. I have an Xbox 360, a PlayStation 2. Plan on getting the rest of the other systems that came out recently. Gotta get a 3DS one day. Definitely gotta pick up a 3DS. A lot of epic games coming out. Bravely Default came out. There's some touchscreen stuff. I'm gonna be posting a few demos on my channel too about 3DS games. I'm gonna start doing that more often when I find them on the Wii U. I usually just go to the Wii U and I record them, and especially if it's a really epic game, I will post it on my channel. I have different sections, different playlists. Just look around. There's about 60 playlists on here that you guys can find. So I hope you guys like that. So anyways, what the hell was I talking about the video before? This is episode 33, if I haven't said that. At least I believe it's episode 33. I might be wrong. I might be wrong. A lot of other videos that I've been doing lately, I've been wrong on the numbers. But thankfully, you guys can read the title. Thankfully, right? So I was talking about being in a relationship and shit like that. What did I say at the end? I think that's what I left off on. Before I go into that, do you guys hate when, like, you, I don't know if you guys do any commentary or if you guys talk on videos or if you speak in public, but, you know, like, when you're talking, when you're actually talking on, a video and somehow the audio, or not, but sometimes you get interrupted and you're on the roll, like, you know, you feel like you're on the roll, you're just doing whatever, and then somebody comes along and they fuck it up. And it's like, now you're off your vibe and all that shit. Well, I feel like that because I was on a roll. I was like, yeah, I feel like talking. I feel kind of hype, energetic compared to what I was last time or 3 videos ago. And I keep referring to 3 videos ago. Like, next video, I'd be like 4 videos ago. Fuck, man. It's just what it is. I was sick. I probably shouldn't have been doing any commentary. I probably shouldn't have been playing any games. But, you know, the gamer in me would just not let that shit sit. Would not let that shit sit. I'm feeling pretty good right now, though. I took a shower. I cut my hair. I trimmed up everything. Everything. Hello, ladies. And, no, I'm just saying, though. Let me get back to the lady thing. But I'm just not, I won't say, did I say this last video? I don't know. I was trying to say some shit like, I was thinking that I have urges like everybody else, you know what I mean? Like, I'm normal. I'm human. I'm a guy. But I'm not a dick, but so I'm not going to use anybody or anything, because I'm not looking for any kind of relationship, because too many fake people around there, too many shady people, too many liars, too many people can't handle a real relationship, and that's on the real. You try to be a certain way, and then, like, you get screwed over, that shit threatens you. Like, I think, I don't know if I said this last video, so I'm sorry if I'm repeating myself. Either way, you're getting a refresh or recap. I feel like certain shit happens to you throughout your life, and it can threaten to change who you want to be or who you are. And that's up to you to decide what's important enough and who can break down those boundaries, even though the shit's hard to sustain or keep that shit up. It's hard to keep your walls up. So, like, I kind of have my guard up on a lot of things. I don't really trust anybody because a lot of people have done me dirty and done me wrong. And, you know, like, I just don't feel like going through the shit right now. And nobody seems worthy or fucking trustworthy enough. Even friends, man. Friends have betrayed me and did stupid shit I never thought they would do. Well, wait a minute. Some of them I thought they would do. I just never thought they would do it to me. So I guess I wasn't the fucking special one. I was the fucking cousin. Anyways, man, I don't know. I just kind of, I'm not really focused on that. You know what I mean? I'm not saying I don't think about it because I am normal, but I'm not trying to. It's kind of like one of those things. If something ever did happen, it just happened, but I'm kind of like iffy, and I won't let it happen, you know? I mean, there's a lot of things you need to do. Like, once you experience a few things, like, you went without for so long, you know what I mean? Like, when you're younger, you don't do any of this weird shit, and then when you're older, it's like, once you experience stuff, you're just like, oh, okay, that's that, you know? Like, I don't know, I'm not trying to say that you don't want that stuff still, you don't want to try to be in a relationship, you don't want to try to interact with the opposite sex and all that shit, but, well, when I say interact, I don't want to say, like, sexual stuff, but, I guess sexual stuff, butt stuff. Alright, then, I don't know, man, this is getting weird, but anyways, I'm just going to continue watching this video, talking about this video. I try not to get hung up with women out here because I did that last time. Where I live right now, or the state that I live in, I don't want to live here. I'm just kind of here for now. And I think last time I said I was going to do it, and I did, I got with this chick, and then I was going to leave. I was actually going to leave. This is before I even got with her, and she started crying and stuff like that. Because I was leaving her, she called me a jerk, and I'm like, we didn't even do nothing. Like, when I say we didn't do anything, we weren't anything. Like, we didn't anything. You know what I mean? But she got really attached to me, and it's like, I remember I was actually going to leave. I was going to go back to a different state that I was going to go to, and I remember her just hugging me, man. Like, she would not let me go, and I was just like, yeah, I was hugging her, and I was trying to talk to her, like, you know, everything's okay, you know? Like, I'll still talk to you and stuff. It's not like I would stop knowing you just because I'm not in the state. And I can honestly say we never did anything. Me and her, we never messed around. Did we mess around? No, we did a little flirtatious shit, but before we got together, she just kind of made me feel bad, but I wasn't, like, pressured and staying. Because I didn't know where I was going to go was kind of iffy too. So it's just like, I don't know, I could stay here. And at least I know, like, somebody cares about me out here and all that shit. You know what I mean? I'm just not trying to be weird, but I hope you guys get what I mean. So I'm out here and I stayed for the chick, and then she ended up fucking me over too. And it was just kind of weird, and I was just like, whatever. After that, I was just like, whatever. I don't even want to try. You know what I mean? Some people make that shit a priority, and they're like, I have to be with somebody, I have to get somebody, I have to do this. No, you don't. You just have to worry about yourself. That's all you have to do. Until the time is right. Then you can fucking pursue the bullshit. If that's what you want to do, then that's what you got to do. Make sure you find the right person. Or at least that's just how I feel. I think a lot of people rush into shit, and they don't do shit. There's other people that, you know, there's other situations where you try to do something, and it doesn't work out. And, people play games. I want to say women play a lot of games, and they're really immature. More immature than you think, because, like, you always thought, like, oh yeah, well, guys are just immature fucking dicks. Like, you always hear that shit. Guys are immature. Guys are, blah blah blah. Guys, you know? No, man. Fucking women are immature. You know, like, there's a time to be goofy and time to fuck around. And I just feel like a lot of women just cannot handle that level, and they cannot think straight. I don't know if they see opportunities or whatever. It's like that little, I'm picking shit, like, they see something else they think is a good idea at the time, just like anyone else, but this is the shit that I went through with women. Like, it seems like they're trying to weigh out whatever, you know what I mean? And then they ended up fucking up, or they end up fucking you over, and it's like, there's no reasoning behind this shit. Honestly, there's not. Like, half the shit that I've gone through is just garbage. It's like, you made some fucking weird decision at some stupid-ass time. You're under an influence or whatever the fuck. I mean, I can go for a lot of things, but I guess you guys know what I'm saying. Friends fuck you over. People, I don't really trust a lot of people. And I don't like when people try to act like they know me, because they don't know me, and I don't know you. I'm cool with talking to people. I'm open. I'm open to chatting with people and stuff like that, but I'm not gonna just let everybody know everything off the bat about me. There's a lot of things I let people know through some of my other videos, but then I don't really feel that's not too personal to me, at least, compared to the other shit that I, you know, keep to myself, because it's my shit, you know. It's like, it doesn't need to go, we don't need to go into all that shit, you know what I'm saying? Damn, when did this game series get into some fucking game day lifestyles or some shit like that, right? I want to know if you guys find this more interesting than me actually playing the game, because actually I'm not even talking about the game. Half the time I'm not even looking at this fucking screen. Like I said, this is post-commentary, and this game was already recorded. This gameplay was already recorded about 2 to 3 weeks ago. I was just sick, and honestly didn't feel like coming back watching the video, because I just played it, and I knew it was a long dungeon, and you know how, like, these dungeons are in these RPG games. You have to be in the fucking mood to do them. You have to be in the mood. Wow. So I was in the mood, and I played the game, and then I got sick, but I was sick, and I was like, you know what? I think the fans deserve better than that. People that want to watch this. So I do apologize for those, like, 3 or 4 videos that were just, I wasn't even talking straight. And then you could tell the audio was messed up, and I had to do a lot of editing in them. And there's a lot of sounds in the background that I actually tried to edit out. but some of them didn't come out well, and I think it kind of even messed up. It kind of made the audio more dense or something. I don't know if that's a correct term, but this felt like something was missing in the audio. I don't know if you guys felt that way either. You guys are the ones watching it over. I just scanned through it and see if it sounds alright. You gotta think though, these are long ass videos. I don't have time to go over all of them. Take a breath, game day. I hope a lot of shit's making sense, man. I'm really anxious to see or hear what people have to think, what people think about what I've been talking about. If people have anything to say, that's not too personal. That doesn't make them feel like they're leaving too much out there for random people on YouTube, because you know, it's your lifestyle. You ain't got to say much. Just like I don't got to say much, but I'm over here conversating, and I don't mind sharing simple shit, because it is simple shit. You know what I mean? It's not nothing big to me that when it comes down to dating or mentioning stuff when it comes down to women. Shit. I might make a few videos on my Real Talk. My Real Talk playlist, I might do something about women again. Like, there's a lot of things I have in my mind. I actually have a little notepad where sometimes I'll come up with shit. Like, I'm like, oh, I want to talk about that. But I just have to be in the mood, you know? Like, I haven't even put anything in that playlist for a while. I mean, there's enough in there that should sustain anyone. There's a few topics that I thought would have got more views or more action or more interaction. You know what I mean? I care about views, but I don't care like that. I don't know why I said that. That probably makes it sound worse, but that's not what I'm going about. I like people coming to the channel, and sometimes people just need somebody to talk to. And I can say that honestly, personally, because I've been there in that situation where you feel like you don't have anybody to talk to. I don't know why you would choose me or why you would come to my video, but I'm just saying, I'm a cool enough guy like that. I have experience in stupid shit. That's right, stupid shit. And even some women have said, oh, you're a good listener, you're all this stuff, but it's like, you gotta get to know me. I wouldn't suggest just coming here and saying random shit unless you don't really care and you want some fucking answers now. Then, you know, Dr. Phil, Dr. J shit in this bitch. That's random to say. I know you guys can hear the bird in the background. Can you guys hear the bird in the background? I think there's somebody mocking him in the background. The bird likes to sing at nighttime, and people in the house start fucking whistling at him, making it worse. And it's like, just let the bird wind down. Let him wind down. He always does this around this time. It's like about 7 o'clock or something right now. So yeah, I felt like talking, man. And I was just like, let me come back and do this, because I'm not going to have time to do it. As you're watching these videos, I'm probably playing Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze, or I probably started posting them. I don't know if you guys have seen it. I think you guys should go watch some of those videos. They're really good. Well, I don't know if they're really good, because I haven't even played it yet. I hope they're really good, because I'm going to go through it blind. And I will say this right now so people know, and I'll refer to this video and probably that one of those videos. I'll be like, oh yeah, one of my evolution videos, I said this shit. I didn't look up anything besides the trailers, you know what I mean? I mean, there's nothing else you have to look up. I'm not going to look up how to beat any boss. I'm not going to look up how to play anything. I'm not going to look up anything else than what I've seen on the trailer. I know some people have already looked at people play. And a few people tell me they're going to play the game, and I'm like, I don't know. People can't be me, you know what I mean? And when I say that, I mean that they can't. They're not satisfied for what they've already seen enough to play the game. They have to watch somebody get through the whole game and then try to go play it. And I already talked about this. I just think it's a waste to do that. I mean, that's a personal idea right there, so please don't take that to heart. But I think that's a waste to go watch somebody play a whole game and then come back and play yourself knowing everything that's going to happen. Like, what's the point? But either way, Donkey Kong is not like that. You have to be a G at the game, and why am I stalling out on this shit? What was I doing at that point in time? I have no clue. Shit, man. Now I forgot what I was going to say. cold in this motherfucker. It's cold. I just think if you're going to play a game, you probably shouldn't watch all the gameplay on it. You know what I mean? I know people that say they beat in games because they watch the fucking playthrough. I played this game before. No, you haven't. Why not just say I watched somebody else beat it, just like a real person would do? Like, it's like when you're younger. That's something I think little kids would do. Little kids would be like, oh yeah, I beat this. But as an adult, man, and coming in here lying about simple shit, why you gotta lie for it? That's the thing with me. I don't like liars. I don't like people that will make up random shit and just, I mean, one lie sets up another lie and then you get caught in it and then you get mad at me for fucking calling you out. If I call somebody out on the lie, then that's your own shit, man. That's your fault, not my fault. If you feel bad about it, then do something about it. Fuck. Don't lie. Yeah, that felt good to say. So, oh my god. What do I feel like? I feel like some kind of talk show host or some shit right now when it comes down to, why the fuck am I going down these steps? Alright, whatever. I feel like this is not my, oh, is this a secret area? What the fuck? Somebody spotted me in here. Alright, the video kind of wigged out right there. Did it catch up? Okay, it's only 1 second off, I think. Yeah, I can hear, oh, he's upstairs. What the fuck is that about? He's sitting right here in front of me? No? I don't know what that was, man. I'm trying to figure it out. Like, yeah, I'm looking at the screen. Like, what the fuck? I was like in deep conversation with you guys, and then I come back and I start talking about some random shit. Like, what the fuck's wrong with Game Day today, huh? So, yeah. I kind of want to take a break from YouTube. I do. I think I posted so much shit on here, it needs to be soaked up by everyone. Everyone that's looking for videos, and the more I post, the more people just like, a lot of shit gets put on the back burner. People come to the channel, they probably don't look around, and I want them to look around. I want them to see all the stuff I posted. I mean, yeah, I do post it for me mostly, but I'm not saying I don't post it for anyone else. Because there's people that are actually wanting to see this shit. There's people that ask me all the time, when are you going to post this? When are you going to do that? Or why haven't you posted this anymore? Do you play this anymore? Can we play this? I'm like, okay, we can do whatever. I really don't mind. But, what was I thinking though? I mean, I don't think anybody puts anything on YouTube for not to have any attention for it, you know? I mean, it's cool to interact with people, even because, like, you might not meet these people in your real life. You might not meet these people in real life at all. Anybody you talk to online, it doesn't have to be like that, though. I think people take shit too far out of content. And, another thing I want to ask you guys, like, when it comes down to, meeting people, like, this is something that I'm a tie into, online, because it has to do with online. Like, some people do online dating. You know that shit? Yeah, some people have done that. Like, I've actually had people back in my past, like, I think when I was younger, like, these women try to talk to me. And I say these women try to talk to me, because there's no, like, when I, my little mind frame is like, my little mind frame, fuck that, my big mind frame, my mind frame is thinking, I would never try to date anybody, through online, because who the fuck are these people, right? Just like anybody else that would teach you when you're younger, oh, you don't talk to strangers, you don't date strangers, you don't, I mean, but it's like, damn, everybody's interacting online and everything these days, and there's so many sites, and this point in age, at this day and age, there's so many fucking things like that, where you date people online, and you date, you go to these chat sites, and you meet these people, and some people have actually found happiness through this shit. I mean, if it's a legit site, not no booty call site, man. I'm telling you, not a booty call site. I know a lot of you guys are thinking, oh yeah, he goes to the booty sites. No, I never go to those, and I never would. The only time I ever had anything, like I had like Facebook, or let's go back even farther than that. We had MySpace. I was on there, never trying to look for some random chicks on there to holler at. I would talk to people on there, but I never met any of them, you know what I mean? Never went to go meet any of these people. I remember even one chick trying to get real serious with me. Like, she was like calling me every day. She was saying she's gonna come visit me in the summertime. And I think she lived on the east side. I was in the west. I live on the west coast. She's like all the way on the east. She was talking about coming out here with her cousin. I'm like, damn, you don't even know me. And I'm like kind of scared though, because I never seen the chick. But she was talking about all this shit, and I don't remember actually what happened. But obviously that didn't fall through. But, like, you get kind of older, and I mean, if you don't have experience in shit, people always knock shit they don't have experience in. Do you notice that? And I think I was like that, too. I was like, oh, I would never do this and that. And then you kind of think about it. It's like everybody you meet is actually a stranger, right? As an adult, you should be wary enough. You should have the smarts to be able to decide or whatever what's good enough for you, what's not good for you. Usually when you go meet somebody that's, you know, new or something, if you did meet somebody online, or something, I would advise you go meet them with a group of people, you know, not just you by yourself, especially if you're a female. Shit, that can go for guys too, though, but I'm gonna say especially if you're a female, you know, you don't just go by yourself. You take like at least three people. I would take three people with me, you know. You go meet this person, I don't give a fuck. If he doesn't like the I would say it because most of the time it's probably gonna be the guy that wouldn't like the circumstances. But if he really was into you, then he should be down with that. But what was I saying? Why are I even talking about this online shit? This online dating? I'm just thinking, what's the difference? Oh yeah, I'll bring up something else. What's the difference between dating somebody? What's the difference between walking up to somebody in a fucking Walmart, in a store or down the street or whatever, saying, hey, how you doing? You don't know this person, right? I know that there's a difference between a screen. If you never seen a person talk or you never seen anything about them, that's the same thing though. What happens if you're doing, what happens if you guys are webcamming? Then you see this person, they see you, and that's that, right? So what's the point otherwise? Person can be the same person he is that you thought he was or wasn't through a screen or in real life. You know what I'm trying to say? So I don't know why people act like it's such a difference, or if it's, I mean, it's kind of a difference. Or, I mean, it's more of a, it's more crazy, man. But it's like, it just seems like this day and age is what everybody's doing. Like, people are doing everything online. People are getting in trouble online. Everything has to do with fucking texting, cell phones, anything that's a social link. Anything that's a social link, people are on. There's like little social links that are out there. What's that one that's called Flicks or some shit like that, or Pics, the one you just take a quick picture, Pic Chat, or I don't know what the fuck. I heard about it. I seen the creators on a show before, like these teenagers or something, or not teenagers, maybe some college students or something. I don't know, these fools. I don't know, there's a lot of little sites out there like that, so what's the difference, you know what I mean? I mean, I just think the world's moving on, and some people are getting left behind. And you can't think the way you thought like 10 years ago, you know, it's not the same world. And that's the same thing what people would have said 10 years ago. They would have said the same shit they're saying today, or at that point in time to the people in their generation or the people in the past generation. You know what I'm saying. You know I'm right. So hit the like. Not playing, but just fucking comment, respond. How do you guys feel about that? Same thing goes for me when I even told this to another homie on that plays Xbox or, you know, that plays online. I'm like, what's the difference between somebody hollering at you, not hollering, like not like that, like somebody trying to befriend you on a gaming system, like Xbox, right? Somebody sees one of your videos online, and then, or they see you in a match, and then they send you a friend request, right? Then you say no. You say no, I don't want to talk to this random, I don't want to talk to this stranger. It makes sense, right? He goes, well, yeah, he's a stranger. I don't really know this guy. And then you look at their profile and you're like, oh, whatever. And then what's the difference between them coming to your channel or them coming to whatever your fucking site is and saying, hey, how you doing? Will you add me on here? And you accepting. I've seen this happen. And I thought to myself, what is that about? Like, if you're going to deny somebody online that's actually playing in-game with you, and then you're going to fucking promote somebody, you're basically going to automatically give this guy the go-ahead just because he came to your channel or your site and said hello, you know? What's the difference? You guys see what I'm saying? There's people that do that. There's people that have done that. And I just thought it was funny and it was something to point out. So once again, don't take it to heart. Just check that and let me know what you think about that, especially if it applies to you. I don't know if anybody's watching it that it applies to, but you know what I'm saying. Have people online. This goes for like Facebook or Twitter or anything like that, where you try to socialize with people, and it's the same shit just like in real life. Nothing's changed. People are shady as fuck. People don't holler. People don't talk to you when you talk to them, or people are not keeping in contact with you. But at the same time, then they wonder why later on you fucking delete them, or you're not, you know, you don't talk to them at all anymore, and they're like, oh, we just stopped talking. It's like, no, you stopped talking. Because I was talking to you the whole time. I was sending you messages. And that kind of goes into another thing where you're kind of unappreciated, I want to say. You ever happen to you guys? You guys ever feel unappreciated? Or somebody doesn't take what you do for them? I don't want to say in consideration. They don't really think nothing about it. They act like it's normal. It's like, you know, but you can see this person, you can see people complaining, like, especially people that complain. Let's say somebody complains about somebody or somebody complains about other people. And then when you fucking try to do, like, let's say you've been the close friend to whoever forever. This can go for anybody. Guy, girl, whatever. I'm pretty sure you've seen it happen, or you probably are the person that made it happen. Where you're complaining about people being the way they are, and nobody's listening, nobody's caring. But there's always that one person that you know, like you might know this person, and they're always around, and it's like they always listen to you say this shit. And you kind of feel like, well, why are you saying this shit knowing that I'm not like that and I'm right here? Like, have you ever been somewhere, have you ever been there for somebody like that, and you hear them complain, but you never hear them kind of acknowledge that you've been around, you know what I mean? Or they treat you like shit, or they're more worried about people that don't care about them. Let's put it that way. I hate when people worry about people that don't care about them. Like, if they don't care about you, why are you giving two shits about them? You shouldn't have to chase these people down. If they want to talk to you, they want to talk to you. And that's what I'm saying. If they want to be involved with you, they'll find a way to be involved with you, correct? You shouldn't have to do all this random shit just to make these people fucking interact with you or like you. That's how it's always been. That means it's not worth it, you know? And I say that because that kind of shit happens on, especially on these websites, like Facebook or something. You can be friends with somebody and then, like, you know, you've not seen them for years, or maybe you guys are not as close as you were, but then, like, the second you try to reach out, these people don't reach back. They don't reach back, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, and then, if you're gonna be fucking, people are gonna be rude about it, and it's like, you know, they're gonna start complaining about other people, it's like, you kind of don't want to hear it, you know? It's kind of like, well, you don't even appreciate what you have. Like, you don't appreciate, that's a lot of, damn, man, I can keep going into different subjects. A lot of people don't appreciate what the fuck they have in life, you know what I mean? There's so much shit you can have that's worse. There's so much shit that you have that makes you fucking, what do you call it? I want to say ungrateful, but I don't know. I can't think of the word right now. I think I'm just overthinking it right now. I know what I'm trying to say, though. I'm pretty sure you guys do, too. Anyways, I don't know. I don't know where I want to carry on with that, but maybe it'll come back to me and I'll get back to you guys. But definitely want to play that Donkey Kong. How about that Donkey Kong? Go check out my Nintendo Wii U trailers. I've been posting a lot of stuff in there lately. A lot of stuff that I've seen, especially for Nintendo Direct. There's the Monolith game, basically Xenoblade X. I think we just call it Xenoblade X. I've seen it be called that before, so I like that. Xenoblade X. Definitely looks good. Has the fucking mechs in there. Same kind of gameplay from Xenoblade. This Child of the Children of the Light, or Child of the Light from Ubisoft, another RPG game. Don't know if that's going to be a full retail game or only download only, but it really got my attention. I suggest you go look at it, or go look at the trailer that I... Wait, I didn't put the trailer in there because I couldn't find it. Well, I could have recorded it, but I chose not to. Anyways, I kind of want to go back to that being unappreciated type thing. And I felt that way for a long time at a certain point. And it's like, you know how you try too hard to make somebody, useful? Have you ever tried too hard with certain things and you're just like, well, fuck it, man. This is not worth it, you know? It's like, people can't see you for who you are. Or they can't see you for what's real, or they can't appreciate what you're doing and what you are. You feel like you're nothing to these people in real life, you know what I mean? Like, you ever feel like you're underneath someone? Like, it's like, everything I do just goes unseen. Not like you're doing shit for attention, but it's like, people don't really acknowledge the shit. And then, you're kind of like thinking, well, I do all this shit that these other people are not doing. That's kind of like boyfriend and girlfriend shit. Like, if you're the boyfriend, if you're the friend of the girl and she's dating some other dude, and you kind of like her, you're kind of like, this guy's a fucking dick and he's a douche, but you still fucking, you're hung all over his ass. And that happens. I've seen people try to say, I don't know why women do this, I don't know why people do that. And that's the most inexperienced people, because these are the people that try to act like they would do something otherwise. But most of the time, when a situation presents itself to them, they do the same fucking thing. And it's really funny, man. It's just like, you just don't have experience under your belt. Anybody can say what they would have did in the situation, but you know, you don't know that situation. You're not in that situation, and you probably never will be. No, it's fine. You probably won't. You probably haven't been in the situations that they've been in. You haven't went through. You haven't been what they went through. You haven't walked the mile in their shoes. All that good shit. You know what I'm talking about. So it looks like we've made it through another video, and it's coming toward an end. I don't know if I'm going to be this talkative as I am today when it comes down to me playing the game again when it comes down to me playing live, I don't know if I'm going to be this energetic because I'm going to be worried about the game. But maybe I'll think of some shit to talk about while I'm fighting these guys. It's not really hard to fight them. It's click, point, and press. That's all the game is. But it just depends on what my mood is. And, today, once again, I'm fucking hype. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling fresh. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's because I've been away from the game. When you come back to a game, you know you got to do something on. You're kind of dreading it. You know what I mean? So I didn't really feel like talking the last couple times I did. But me recording the game post-com on, because I recorded this gameplay when I was sick, and I just didn't talk. So it is what it is. And what am I doing? Am I looking for a save, or do I want to go fight this guy? I think I am going to save it. Right? Yeah, we're not going to go out there, are we? Are we going out there? No, I don't want to go out there. All right then, guys. Thanks for staying tuned. I do appreciate it. Until next time, stay gaming. It's Game Day, baby. And I'm out.